constant life, she had moved to Montreal, where she worked as a sales assistant. Early in 2008, Marilyn began telling her family she no longer felt safe in Montreal and wanted to return to Quebec. In February, she abruptly left her apartment in the rough neighborhood of Montreal and returned to her parents' house. She took two more trips to Montreal to collect her belongings. Marilyn's mother confronted her about what had happened in Montreal that caused her to return home so suddenly and leave everything behind. Marilyn did not say, but denied that her problems involved drugs, debt, or a relationship. On the 17th of February, the day after settling in her home, was the day she disappeared. She took only a credit card and left all other identification at home. Her mother asked if she could join her on the walk, but Marilyn said no. An ATM security camera recorded Marilyn attempting to withdraw $60 that afternoon. However, the card was declined. The footage shows her looking behind her several times. She also had a black backpack, which her mother said she did not have when she left the house. At 4 p.m, Marilyn bought a cup of coffee at a cafe. She paid using her credit card. The clerk said that she seemed depressed and eager to leave the store. No one has seen her since then, nor has the credit card been used. Her family reported her missing that evening. At first, the police would not let Marilyn's parents see the ATM security footage, as they considered it to be too upsetting. When they did see it, her mother agreed that her daughter looked helpless. While it's possible that she could have walked the whole 16 miles from her house to the cafe, her family believes that she must have been driven by someone or hitched a ride. In December 2010, 2 years after Marilyn's disappearance, an anonymous person called in. They reported seeing Marilyn numerous times over the past year in Hawkesbury, Ontario, over 300 kilometers west of Quebec City. The person said they'd always seen her with the same young man, but she looked under pressure and captive. Patrons from a downtown restaurant also say they've seen her. In total, there's been over 35 reported sightings of her in this town. The police said they'd investigated these tips, but they led nowhere. Their theory is that Marilyn committed suicide, although no evidence has been found. An old friend of Marilyn named Jonathan reconnected with her in Montreal. 3 months before her disappearance, he had gone to meet her and go to a party. At her apartment, instead of being cheerful, as she usually was, instead she was sad and listening to music in the dark. Her mood improved at the party, but after talking to a friend, she suddenly became anxious and asked to go home. Back at her apartment, she began crying. Jonathan asked what was wrong. He asked if she had been assaulted or witnessed a crime, but she denied it and said it was something worse. She said, "You can't even begin to imagine what I've been through, Joe." Jonathan said, "I tried to get her to say what it was for 3 or 4 hours. I got the impression that she did not want to put